When establishing the value of a stock, merely looking at the current profitability is insufficient. We also need to consider the risk involved with investing in a particular company. In other words, we need to establish what minimum rate of return we would need to get from an investment in a company in order to justify the risk involved. This is known as the required rate of return. Factors that need to be considered in establishing this return are, firstly, the current risk-free rate in government bonds. Secondly, an additional rate of risk required for investment in the stock market. And finally, the specific risk related to a particular company based upon factors within the company and factors in the company's external environment. The sum of all these elements then becomes the required rate of return for a particular stock. As an example, you might be wise to consider an investment in a resources exploration company to be a much greater risk than that of a food retailer. The required rate of return in combination with the financial performance of a company and how much equity was required to generate that performance are the base elements of our intrinsic value calculation. If you think this sounds complicated, you wouldn't be wrong. Climb's analysts use our stock valuation tool, MyClimb, to assist with this process. And you can take advantage of this same information as well. Watch the next videos to see some of the other key things we take into consideration when deciding whether or not to invest in a company.